Hey guys, how you doing? This is a late night video. I don't know where this is all coming from in my head, but you ever have those times where you're laying in bed trying to get to sleep and things just start popping off in your head? With COVID and with all the different things that have been happening, with the changes I've needed to make in my nutrition, in my diet, the workouts, how they've changed, going through the process of not having anything to work out, doing bodyweight stuff, not really being consistent with doing my workouts, eventually getting a hold of some equipment, starting to build kind of my own gym here in my apartment. A lot of things I've had to adjust, right? I had a good conversation, good video with Keto Savage, Robert Sykes, and we talked about how he uses a high fat diet to cut before a bodybuilding competition. I've talked to people like Ella Bruce, Marty Kendall. We talk about nutrient density. We talk about high protein diets. I've tried a lot of different things. High protein, high fat, high protein, low fat, lots of different combinations, PSMF, different things. Where I'm at right now is, well, let's not even talk about that right now. What I want to talk about is through all of these things, one thing has been consistent. High fat, low protein, high protein, low fat, high protein, high fat, zero carb, some carb, keto, paleo, 21-day sugar detox, all these different things that I've tried over the past seven-ish years. The one thing that has been consistent through all of it is the lack of importance in counting calories. Okay? When everything is said and done, the most effective nutrition plans that I have been on have been the ones that do not count calories. And that's for a few reasons, but I just want to address a lot of the feedback that I get when I post things like this video. I get tons of people that say that the only reason I lose fat when I, there was a time when I was doing high protein, low everything. I was doing high protein, moderate fat, zero carbs, because I wanted to see what that would do as far as getting lean, right? Maintaining muscle and cutting my body fat. Right? Building lean, building or maintaining lean mass and cutting my body fat. And it worked. It worked really well. I got down to 9.5-10% body fat. It was easy to maintain. And I felt really good. I maintained my muscle mass. I was as strong. I was setting PRs in all my strength work. I was setting PRs in all my Metcons. And the one feedback that I consistently get is, well, of course you're going to lose fat because you're in a caloric deficit. Okay, the point that I think many people are missing is I was always in a caloric deficit, okay? If you look back at any of the videos or any of the posts that I've got about what I've been doing in my nutrition over the past few years, what I was doing before, I was at, like when I first got into this whole nutrition thing, trying to figure out what works for me and go through this self-education process, I was eating 1,700 to 1,800 calories a day, okay? My BMR was 1,900 at the time, okay? 19 to 2,000. Now, that's a caloric deficit. I was 27% body fat, right? 25% body fat. I was not as strong. Every time I tried to lose weight by cutting more calories, I lost weight, I lost fat, and I lost muscle, right? I was never able to target fat loss, right? You can target fat loss. So when I talk about eating more and losing weight, everybody immediately says, well, you're obviously eating in a caloric deficit because you're still losing fat. That is not the discussion that I'm trying to have. What I'm trying to explain is how the calories don't really matter because I'm adding 500, 700, 1,000 calories in my day, okay, and losing fat, right? So if it was all about calories, then can someone explain to me how I can go from eating 1,700, 1,800 calories a day to eating 2,600 to 3,000 calories a day, right? And I lose 5, 6, 7% body fat. Okay? Sure, let's say my total daily expenditure of energy is 3,000, 3,100, 3,200. If you talk about all the stuff that I do in a day, my workouts and everything, right? The total amount of calories I burn a day, let's say it's 3,100, okay? If I go from 17 to 3,000 and it takes me going to 3,000 to lose 5 or 6% body fat, how is it the calories that made a difference? Okay? Prioritize a protein, use fat as a lever, use carbs as a lever. I talk about not eating carbs a lot, okay? Because I choose not to. I don't see the benefit in it. That doesn't mean you can't. That doesn't mean you shouldn't. Some carbs work for people. Some people can do some vegetables and not have a problem. Whatever works for you, right? Use it as a lever. Carbs are like your booster in your car, your fuel, your octane booster, right? Fat is your regular premium fuel. And then protein is like your oil. It keeps things running, right? You need protein. You need fat. You do not need to put octane booster in your car, in your body. If you want to, that's awesome. Understand what it does and how it affects your body. How does it affect your progress? How does it affect your health? Okay. A lot of people, another topic, a lot of people get confused between how you look and how you are. You can be cut and lean and have muscle. That does not mean squat to are you healthy, right? You were probably more healthy than someone who is not lean and have muscle, okay? But that doesn't mean you don't have autoimmune issues. That doesn't mean you don't have gut issues, skin issues, arthritis, joint pain, who knows what, people that are in shape, right? Look at Bob Harper, great guy, he's in shape, he had a heart attack, right? Right? It's not just about how you look. There's other factors that go into health. When I talk about cutting out carbs, I'm talking about cutting out carbs from a general, functional, holistic view of health, not just will it work for cutting fat, okay? So this is just a late night ramble. Like I said, this stuff was just pinging around in my head, so I just wanted to kind of get it out. It is what it is, guys. You don't need carbs. If you want to eat them, that's awesome. Know what they do, okay? It's not about calories. If it was about calories, then the calories from protein would make a much bigger difference in your weight loss than it does, okay? Eating more protein will help you lose more fat. It just does, okay? There's multiple reasons. You can look at some of my other videos as far as that goes, okay? Nutrient density is something you need to focus on. It's a big, big issue, guys. The biggest thing with eating in a caloric deficit, if you look at just straight up traditional diets, okay, eat less, work more. That's awesome. It works to a point, okay? Where it misses is it doesn't talk about what you're eating when you're eating less and optimizing it so that your body gets the most out of it, right? Caloric deficit without nutrient density is starvation, okay? I'm going to say that again. Caloric deficit without nutrient density is starvation, okay? You will lose muscle mass, you will gain body fat, you will increase inflammation, oxidative stress, and increase your risk for cardiovascular disease, dementia, stroke, and all kinds of other issues, autoimmune issues that are just gonna destroy your life, okay? Caloric deficit without nutrient density is starvation. If you want to lose body fat, if you want to increase your health, prioritize protein, get enough fats in, and use carbs as a tool to help you maintain your overall holistic view, right? Keep the palate going, right? Change up flavors, do different things with different vegetables or spices or different things, right? You don't need them. They are not essential. That doesn't mean you can't have them. And there are ways to make them fit. There's plenty of keto stuff out there where you can get carbs in. That's why I'm not even going to talk about carb desserts and all that kind of stuff. For people that have issues with sweets, I would not recommend carb desserts. They can be a trigger and cause all kinds of problems. But that's a whole different discussion, because I can't personally, keto treats and processed food that has keto on the side of it, to me, for the most part, is kind of counterintuitive and doesn't really make sense. So anyways, that's enough of my rant for the night. Hope you guys can get something out of this. I don't know where I was going with it, but I felt like I needed to get it out. So if it works for you, that's awesome. Comment at the bottom. If it doesn't, pass it on. See you.